what did you, what was the text going through your head when you were feeling so nervous?
Trying to, I have a lot of things written, so try to get in the story.
Yeah. And physically?
Breathing, because I'm like, when I'm nervous, I'm going up and up,
yeah,
up,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I'm doing the
sound.
That's
what I see,
yeah.
And that's what I hear as
yeah.
well. But the energy gets very
yeah,
high.
Yeah, yeah.
So I think, you know, where I've said already, we are all different and we all have our own ways of dealing with. But I think if that's something you recognize in your playing, that your energy, you're already quite hyper, and then you get nervous and you get more hyper, find a way to.
Yeah.
So it can be really, think of the ground underneath your heels. Think about your heels pulling down to your feet or, you know, something just to, because everything got kind of a little,
yeah.
slightly hysterical.
Yeah.
I liked a lot of the cadenza, but I wonder if there's a way that we can make it sound as if Mozart wrote it. I think that's the, you know, I think
maybe
it's
more connected.
It's a little too extreme.
Yeah,
I think is what.
Okay.
So, I think all the gestures are really nice, and you made me laugh, and you surprised us, and you showed us thematic material and everything. But I didn't believe for one moment that Mozart wrote it. And I think if you can. If you listen to his, you know, for many of the piano concertos, he wrote the cadenza. So we can understand what he would have maybe thought of as a cadenza and just have a little bit more connection to that.
Okay.
I
didn't thought about that actually. I was like trying to, what do I want to show?
Yeah.
And then not
yeah.
thinking about Mozart.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's exactly how it came out. And
yeah.
and we heard, you know, your extremes of dynamic and of contrast of character, but it felt a little bit a splash of color here and a
yeah.
splash of this, and I didn't
okay.
understand the context so
yeah.
much.
Okay.
So I think context would be a word that I would give to the cadenza to try and find a more natural structure to it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I liked a lot of the energy of the exposition. I thought was terrific, and you were doing a lot of the things. Thank you that we talked about. Another good student, almost doing too much. So, for example, just to pick a random bar, do you have bar numbers?
Yeah, I have them.
So, bar 86. Yom, beep, bom, beep, bom, beep, bom. And probably I said sometime a few days ago, longer low note, and now it sounds like longer, longer, a little bit uneven. So, don't forget a place like that, to take that specific example, the result should be two evenly balanced notes. And to do that,
okay.
we slightly lengthen the low and slightly shorten the top. But they should not know that. We should not know that. So it's your kind of manipulating your instrument so that the end
yeah.
result is two even notes.
Yeah.
So some of the gestures I felt a little too sudden.
Yeah.
To a little
okay.
sort of violently from this, and then in the cadenza became an exaggerated version of that. So, you know, I think we should, if we just take a step back and think, what is the overall character we're trying to create? Is something very elegant and effortless.
Okay.
You know, that it just, something sounds very, they say that Mozart is too easy for children and too difficult for adults. and there's something of the simplicity of Mozart that we need to find back a little bit. Of course, we are showing all the things we can do. That's what we've been talking about
mm-hmm.
in the recent days, to make and to show in an audition the range that you have.
Yeah.
But I would say do it in bigger blocks.
Yeah.
So that the first subject is all basically in an open maestoso energy, and then we have the biggest contrast comes with the second subject.
Mm-hmm.
For while we're talking about the second subject, you did this nice and light. I didn't understand the relation between these two bars, 51 and 52.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe we can show bar 50. Can you just play so people know where it is? Okay, so then suddenly the bottom fall. You
yeah.
take us to the and you let us fall in the hole.
Yeah.
Maybe this would be a place where we can say, like we did in this beginning of second subject, rhythmic here, da 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 da, melodic. We can
mm-hmm.
say the same here, and then bottom. So we have the feeling of these two bars, 51 and 52, being somehow still part of the same
mm-hmm.
character in the opera.
Yeah.
Now, technically, there's one thing that I would love you to think about.
Yeah.
And that is the clarity of repeated notes.
Mm-hmm.
I think you've got it in your toolkit. I think you can do it, but too many, even when you played this, I didn't hear two D's over the bar line, I don't hear two B flats.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I need to change my battery of a hearing aid, but no, it's... We need a little bit more definition, a little bit clearer text.
Yeah.
We're turning this into a flute opera, and we need to understand what the text of each aria is about.
Yeah.
Okay. So lots of places. I think here it didn't help that you played so loud. Then there's a lot of sound, and to play clear repeated notes in a thick texture is quite difficult. So you're making life difficult for yourself, showing a forte at the beginning here. This is why
okay.
I would suggest, I mean, you don't have to do it, but I just know that you're making life difficult for yourself if you do that.
So you start
so
more soft.
So we mentioned a few times, the line is going down, so go down with the line, and then the next bar is crescendo, and then we will hear clearer repeated notes. It's not wrong what you did, but I couldn't hear the repetition. I couldn't
sure.
hear the texture. What else to talk about? I think we can go back to the opening.
Mm-hmm.
Thinking a little bit grander, more maestros. Are you thinking in four in a bar or two in a bar?
Two.
Okay. Are you sure?
No. Not sure.
It felt kind of quite...
It depends. Yeah.
I wonder whether we can find the poise. The poise is a good word. You know those Mozart dresses that the ladies had to wear and they had to go through doorways sideways? You know, they couldn't really run and, you know, something about that kind of elegant poise. You couldn't put your hands down. Your hands down was out here. You know, we need to have that feeling that everything is a little, yeah, there's
yeah.
a bit more space. Let's do the beginning. So short, so that you can take us. Can you just show me how you play the end of the second bar? It's a little too busy. I like your micro phrasing. Each beat I like.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I'm losing the line, and then we have the cadence points. Show me the end of the second bar.
Yeah.
So I hear the scale being cut a little bit into three chunks, and then then we lose the sense of it being one sentence. Can we do once without the trill? More direction to the D, the low D. Okay, and the B not collapsed. It's still inviting us to keep listening. It's not the end of the story.
Okay.
Yes. So it's still elegantly finishing the phrase, but we want to keep listening.
Yeah.
Now I think you're doing double tonguing. Can we find a way of either a more active double tonguing, or maybe better single tonguing? I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Can we try?
So you want it shorter or more?
I don't understand the text. Now take us through to the low D better. So I have one or the other. Is that the option? Either I get the direction or I get the micro phrasing. I want both. We need to enjoy that G. Enjoy is called a G. No, it's called a J. the feeling that the G in the low register is where it's about. Technically, a little more space for the D. Can we just go from the B that you finished the first phrase on? And chromatically, di da di da da. Your tongue is a little bit getting in the way of the sound.
Okay.
think of it as being mostly hum, hum. Good, let's do the beginning once again. So direction and articulation and not collapsing the first cadence. Tells a very interesting story. I wonder if we can get them being part of the same story. Mm-hmm.
So you're not connecting the D to the D. Put the phrase.
Okay. Bim bam 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 bam.
Is it an upbeat or not an upbeat?
What do you think?
I thought no.
Yeah, I think no too.
Oh, okay.
Bim bum ba-dum bum bum. Bim bum ba-dum bum bum. Can we just do that? Yeah. I think it's just there's too much happening in each part of the phrase, and I think you're just losing the direction through it.
Mm-hmm.
Of the D's, but otherwise perfect. Yum, bum, ba dum. For us,
yeah, okay,
and I think for you, yeah, okay. Let's go on. Second subject. Okay, so this is contrast, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the energy of the first subject is this way. The energy of second of the subject. Dum dum dum. We talk about babies. I think the second bar doesn't need to be any way longer than the first bar. So
okay.
The crescendo will happen.
Yeah.
and then it doesn't have enough contrast with the first subject. So this is all the second aria in the opera, and it's not anymore the king speaking to his people. It's, did you hear what the king said? And it's, oh, ridiculous, I'm joking or something. It's, so the contrast is between the first subject and the second subject, not between the first bar and the second bar.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay, can we do the original articulation? Da-da-di-ya-da-da-da. Remember when you're whispering, it needs to be more articulated? She asks a question and you answer it. Yeah. First homework, clean copy.
Yeah.
Because there's so much information. I mean, I thought I wrote a lot in my music. At a certain point you can't see what is important.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what I hear.
Mm-hmm.
That you're doing so many details here.
Yeah, because actually I had like a changing character for every part. Like this was drama, this was more funny thing.
Yeah. It's too much.
Yeah.
It's then we don't understand that it's one character speaking. I love the contrast, but I think it's in bigger blocks than you're making it. Basically.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. But I like your articulation. Thank you. Nice. Three long notes are too important. Suddenly, why the C takes so much importance, and exactly the same place.
Mm-hmm.
And the other one is the listening aid. C, B, A. And eyebrows and everything was incredible. And I think this is what Mozart should be like. That we work in all the details, polishing this, think about this thing, but in the end should sound like you just We say in Dutch that you shake it out of your sleeve, which is Mozart. Okay,
yeah.
That's what's hard
okay.
about it. But in order to do that, we have to think very carefully. So let's show, just show me the shape of the A major scale. Okay. Like a broken record, my God. The same in the next bar. Two bars later. Just one tiny detail, we don't need to do it again, but it's a variation. We need to understand it's a variation. I hear the B and the A too loud. Sorry for my singing. Shall we do last time from 78?
Yes. And I was trying to sing the note and play the melody and stay on the bass note.
Uh-huh.
It was hard.
Yeah. No, but you can, you know, we all have a kind of a smartphone. You can just record the bass line. So I think you will learn how to, I think it will help you to phrase if you're thinking more from the bass. I think you're thinking too melodically because you have a beautiful sound and getting a little seduced by your sound, maybe. But Mozart, you know, why is it called classical? Because they referred back to the like the Greek temples with all the structure and the ratios, the perfect math. My father was a mathematical teacher, so all these perfect ratios. He came into my living room when I first bought my apartment, and he said, "Oh, this room is perfect dimensions. It must be a perfect ratio, you know, this mathematical perfect ratio, which they discovered in ancient Greek." And Mozart is the same, Haydn the same. You know, we have these very strong phrase structures. It's not nearly as complicated harmonically as Bach. It's transparent, we can see the form. We have this sonata form very strongly. All this framework is so important with Mozart. And I think your frame needs to be a little clearer. And then you can be free, like we were talking about earlier, with the inside each beat, that there can be a spontaneity, a flexibility, but only if the frame is clearly structured. Yeah. In the last minutes, shall we just do a little bit on the cadenza, see if we can bring it a little bit into... it's not to do with the notes. It's because I like the musical ideas behind it.
It's too much.
But it's too much.
Yeah.
Can we try again?
Mm-hmm. To listen, okay, what is the answer? Okay.
Di-da-di-a-da-da-da. Decoration. And the interesting is the B. You're in three time, right?
I think it's
actually what's happening.
Okay.
And that's why it feels a little, we've been so strong in 4/4. Can we do the rhythm he writes here? See if it works. Forceful.
Mm-hmm.
So we have sort of one high point.
Okay.
Because at the moment there's a high point and then another high point and then a bar blah, 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 and then another high point. So which one is?
Yeah, of course.
Modulate to the major, and he doesn't do that in the body of the movement. So leave a little bit more surprise for that.
This one.
Yes.
Yeah.
Keep the line, keep the simplicity, look, search for the simplicity. Nice. I like that.
Very nice.
And then there's space, you see, then we want to keep listening and you do some, you surprise us and that's nice. But the moment that it changes is this scale coming down here, right? Da di da di da di da di da. We already understand it's G minor. You don't have to tell us it's G minor. In da di da di da di da di da. Dum 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 dim dum dum dum. We've done a few times, no, in the body.
Yeah. I'm playing it like this, then this, and then starting again from here.
Yes, but make sure that we have the right number of beats in the bar, if
okay.
you like, just
yeah.
so that we understand the logic, because it's such a strong logic that he's established
yeah.
in the movement. Then if you upset that too much.
Okay, so there also stay really
not
the,
not not. Not too Swiss. On time. Accurate. All good things. But it's a cadenza, so
yeah.
of course the fantasy. That's
mm-hmm.
great. But we need to understand the frame underneath.
Yeah.
Should we do one more time? Maybe it's me being stupid and I don't understand. One more time, then last time. Yes,
I'm cutting this off, and then maybe I should do one.
Oh, da-di-da, maybe. Oh, da-di-da, or something.
Yeah.
Would be.
Okay.
I don't know.
Yeah, yeah.
Wonderful! But don't try and tell us your whole range in every bar. In case they shout next after the first phrase.
Okay.
Keep the sentence complete. Great, beautiful playing.